where you live.
And now your WeatherMax forecast with meteorologist Caitlin Moffitt.
Good morning and happy Monday. If you're just tuning in this morning, rain is still continuing to fall across the region, and it's been falling since about 12:30, 1 o'clock for most of our western counties. As it started early yesterday evening, bringing actually some severe weather to folks down in the southern portions of Minnesota, even in the Twin Cities, saw some stronger storms. But as it moved north and east, temperatures were a little bit cooler and, of course, less instability. We are not seeing that severe threat. There are no watches. There are no warnings. But you'll do notice there are some heavier pockets with those yellow and even red indicating in there. We do have some heavy rain falling as well as some isolated thunder. We also had just a few reports of hail in the Duluth-Proctor area. Very small, though, in terms of hail size. This is Canal Park this morning. We are about 50 degrees, so a little bit cooler down here than we are up on the hill, and that's thanks to that east-northeast wind coming off of the lake right now at about 3 miles per hour down here. But the further inland you go behind that cold front, winds are much more breezier. So here's a quick look up on the hill. 23-mile-hour winds coming out of the northwest. Hibbing, Grand Rapids, Bemidji, all seeing winds over 15 miles per hour, and that's going to continue this morning and even into this afternoon. You'll see Ironwood and Mercer haven't seen the cold front yet, so winds are actually still out of the south, but also very breezy out of the south at about 18 miles per hour. Those breezy winds are not going away anytime soon, as we've got some series of cold fronts the next 3 days or so. So today we'll see that cold front sweep through. Temperatures will climb into those upper 50s. We'll see rain showers taper from west to east this morning into the afternoon hours. And then we've got our next cold front Tuesday morning. But this next cold front is also fighting with a high pressure that will start to kind of inch that cold front out of the way. Tuesday morning, just a quick shot of shower is possible from Duluth and north. Tuesday morning, very light rain expected and then mostly sunny skies. Temperatures back in those 50s. Wednesday, we've got a strong low pressure system setting up. So as the warm front extends for the region come Wednesday morning, that will bring a round of rain showers. And then as that cold front behind the low kind of progresses, as that low pressure moves across the region, that will continue to bring those rain showers off and on all day, and even some flurries for folks to the north, because temperatures start in those upper 40s and they dwindle as the day goes on into Thursday morning. Here's a timing out on the future cast. You're right, 1 o'clock p.m. You'll see the rain. Cold front sets up off to our east, still bringing rain to our eastern counties, but Minnesota all in the sun, as we'll see plenty of sunshine come this afternoon. Partly cloudy skies overnight with that very, very brief shot of some rain you'll see here on the future cast. Not picking up a whole lot on this model here by Tuesday morning, and then more sunshine all Tuesday afternoon. Clouds increase yet again, though, Wednesday morning at 11 o'clock. That's our next system setting up with that warm front, and that's going to bring kind of rain showers, a little bit of scattered activity, become more widespread as the day continues into your Wednesday night. Today, temperatures in the upper 50s up on the hill, 57 down by the lake, 54 up in Ely, and 52 up in Grand Marais. Pretty chilly to the north, but temperatures all in those low 60s for folks off in northern Wisconsin. And then tonight, they drop into those mid-40s, some even low 40s and upper 30s, like Hibbing, 39 degrees. We should see dry conditions throughout much of the overnight. And then temperatures back in those 50s, a quick shot of rain possible for our northern counties. Wednesday becomes more widespread for the region. Temperatures in the 40s will start to dwindle, though, down into the 30s come Thursday morning, so that chance for some flurries is very, very slim, but there's that chance. And then Thursday, Friday, Saturday should all remain kind of on the drier side because of we have such a cold shot of air coming in, which is going to dry up the atmosphere, of course, for a couple of days. But it's going to feel a little bit like winter the next couple of days.
Yeah.
If we do sit 15 degrees below average.
It sure looks like it. That's I had the heat actually turned on a couple weeks ago. Turned it back off.
Yes.
It was off for the last week and a half, 2 weeks. And
last Friday, we were at 80 degrees, 15 above. This Friday, we're going to be 15 below. I mean, it's just a complete...
And it's so funny because after having a couple cold, very cold days, 80 degrees felt like 90. I walked outside and I was like, this is unbelievable. So
yes, it was very nice, but that is over.
Yeah, going to have to get the jackets back out for the rest of the week.
Yeah.
Thanks, Caitlin.
You bet.